Hallelujah. Glory be to Jesus. Good morning to you all in Jesus' name. It's another new week again. I give glory to God for his grace that woke us up this morning, sound and heard it. Many slept yesterday, they could not wake up. You that is alive, celebrate the grace of God. I thank God for your life. I welcome you to begin daily with Christ. Hallelujah. Begin daily with Christ. And my topic this morning is secure your testimony with prayer. This month, by the grace of God, God told us that it's a month of testimony. So I've come to encourage you that all that God has done for you and everything that he will still do, secure it with prayer. And I'm taking my Bible reading from the book of John 12, 9 to 11. The book of John 12, 9 to 11. I read in Jesus' name. Much of the Jews therefore knew that he was there, and they came not for Jesus' sake only, but that they might see Lazarus also, whom he had raised from dead. But the chief priests consulted that they might put Lazarus also to death, because that by reason of him, many of the Jews went away and believed on Jesus. Hallelujah. We all know the story of Lazarus. Lazarus was dead. He was buried for good 4 days. And Jesus came to the grave of Lazarus. He resurrected him back to life. Now, many of the Jews, they were aware of this. They heard about this. They heard about the testimony of Lazarus. So the chief priest consulted them that they should go not only to see Jesus, but to put Lazarus to death. Have you ever imagined or think about why do they gather together to eliminate Lazarus? Why do they come with the idea and say, let us put Lazarus to death? The Bible say the reason was for them to stop him from testifying. Verse 11 say, because by reason of him, many of the Jews went away and believed on Jesus. As he was telling people what Jesus did, many people were giving their life to God. I've come to encourage you this morning to begin your day with Christ. Begin this new week with Christ. As you begin with him, it will empower you more and more to pray, so that you'll be able to secure your testimony with prayer. Have you ever imagined at times you will see somebody that have prayed for a long period of time for the fruit of the womb, for a new job opportunity, for ministry to revive back. And after God have done the miracle, after sometimes what you will hear is, oh no, she have lost that pregnancy. Something has happened to the baby. The job opportunity God has given to him, he has missed it. Just like the life of the Shunammite woman in the book of 2 Kings 4, if you read 8 to 37, we all saw what happened there. The enemy waited for her to carry the pregnancy for 9 months. They waited for her to enjoy motherhood. They waited for her that people recognize her as a mother. Then they attack. They strike the child. If not grace, that child would have just gone like that. If not grace of God, the woman that has been recognized as a mother before would have gone back being a childless woman. When God does a new thing in your life, I've come to encourage you, don't be carried away with the excitement. Don't be carried away with that broken marriage that God has restored. Don't be carried away with that testimony of new job opportunity that God has given to you. Don't be carried away with that open door that God has opened for you. Don't be carried away with the excitement. When God does new thing for you, before he does it, you have been praying. But after he has done it for you, that is the time that you need to pray more. It is the time that you need to secure that testimony more. If not, the enemy, they are going to come after that testimony. Why? Because they know that the more you testify, the more people hear your testimony, the more they want to know the God you serve, the more they want to believe in your God, the more you are winning soul to the kingdom of God. In the case of Lazarus, they gathered together to stop him from sharing his testimony. They gathered together to eliminate him so that he will not tell people anymore what God has done for you. I encourage you, tighten up your prayer belt to secure your testimony with prayer. Secure the education of your children with prayer. Secure your marriage with prayer. Secure everything that gives you joy that God has given to you with prayer. The Bible says something. It said, the blessing of the Lord that maketh rich. He said, it added no sorrow. For sorrow not to come after the blessing of the Lord, you need to secure that testimony with prayer. You need to pray earnestly so that that testimony will remain with you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I decree and declare upon everyone that is hearing the sound of my voice, in this new week, the mercy of God will speak on your behalf. In this new week, your steps will be ordered by God. In the name of Jesus Christ, I decree and I declare your testimony is secured by the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I decree and declare that broken marriage that God has restored, that job opportunity that God has opened for you, they are secured by the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I decree and I declare that nothing will add sorrow to your joy this week. In the name that is above every other name, I decree and declare you will not be rejected, but you shall be accepted in the resurrected great name of Jesus. In this new week, God will do a miracle that you've not experienced before in your life. In the name of Jesus, and you will live to testify in the name of Jesus. Receive grace to pray as never before in the resurrected great name of Jesus Christ. I decree and declare that every contract of accident in this new week is hereby terminated in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You will not hear bad news in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. No weapon of the enemy will form a fashion against you that will prosper in the name of Jesus. All that you will lay your hands to do this week shall prosper in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you, glorious Father. In your name alone be glorified. For in Jesus' mighty, glorious name, I pray this morning with thanksgiving. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. God bless you all in Jesus' name. Once again, I welcome you all to this new week that you will live to testify in the name of Jesus. Go out there and stand as an ambassador of Christ. Represent Christ. As you do, God will open the book of your chronicle in the name of Jesus. Make up your mind to be happy. Don't allow anything to tamper with your joy in the name of Jesus. Tell somebody about Christ. As you do, your life will never remain the same. God bless you all. Bye for now.